Good morning, children. Now, lesson number 2, parts of a plant. Let us continue. In the last class, we have studied about the parts of plant. The two main parts, one is shoot and the root. These two parts we have seen. And the functions of the root also we have studied. And next, stems. Stems function also we have studied. Now, coming to the another part. Next part is what? Leaf. Leaves are the main part of the plant. Leaves are the main part of the plant. If the leaves are not there, then they cannot make the food. If the roots are not there, then water is not sent to up to the leaves. So that is why leaves are the main part of the plant. Let us study what are the parts are there in the leaf. Now, when you go out, when you see a plant, when you observe it, what happens? You will not find the leaves on the plants in the same size and shape. Do you find this? No, it is little bit different. They are all different sizes and shapes also. Can you see this leaf also? It is totally different. So these are the different types of leaves. You too go out and observe the leaves. Now, these all the leaves are which color? All the leaves are in a green color. Do you know that why these leaves are green in color? Because a substance present in the leaf is called chlorophyll, and chlorophyll gives the leaf green color. It's green color. So that is why, because this chlorophyll present in the leaf, that's why the leaves are green in color. Now, coming to the part, the flat broad part, the flat broad part is called a leaf blade, and one line, one tube is running in the middle of the leaf blade. This is called the main vein. This is called main vein, and the side lines, the side tubes are attached to the main vein. They are called the side veins, and these lines, these veins work like a tube. They carry the water inside the leaf. They carry water and minerals to the leaf, inside the leaf. That's why the leaves are wet. I understood. Now, these are the parts of the leaf. Which color present in the leaf? The green color substance present in the leaf is called chlorophyll. C-H-L-O-R-O-P-H-Y-L-L. Green color substance, that is chlorophyll present in the leaf. Once again, I will explain the flat part. This part is called leaf blade, and the main tube which is running in the middle of the leaf blade is called the main vein, and the side veins are attached to the main vein. They are called the side veins, and these carry the water to all parts of the leaf. That's why if you pinch or break it also, you will find the wetness inside the leaf. And okay, then this part is dark. The front part is dark, and when you turn this leaf, you will find the lighter side, light green color. Front part is dark green color, and the back part is light green color. Okay. Underside of the leaf, you will find the tiny openings. The small openings are there. You cannot see these openings with your naked eyes, because we must see them under the microscope only. When the school reopens, that time I can show you the tiny openings present in the leaf through which the air enters. So these are the parts of the leaf. Now, what do they absorb? They absorb water and air also, carbon dioxide from the air and sunlight. Okay, now these are the parts of the parts and the function. What is the main function of this leaf? To prepare the food. What is the main function of the leaf? Is to prepare the food. Now I'll show you here in your textbook also. Open your textbook, page number 193. You will find the pictures also in this. Can you see this picture? All the leaves, different types of leaves, they are in different shapes and sizes also. So this is the leaf of a papaya leaf. Here you can see the leaf blade, side veins and the main vein. Now I'll read out this paragraph for you. Slowly, all of you, put your fingers and listen to me. Let us now learn about the other parts of the shoot. Walk into a garden and collect as many as leaves you can. Are all the leaves of the same size and shape? No. Observe a leaf closely. What are the parts you see? A leaf has a flat and broad part called the leaf blade. The leaf blade has a vein in the middle called the main vein. You can see a number of side veins branching out from the main vein. Veins carry water and minerals within the leaf. There are tiny openings on the underside of each leaf. They are called stomata. They are called stomata. The stomata, the diagram of a stomata is like this. When you see this diagram, so you will find the stomata in this. So this is the stomata, picture of diagram of a stomata, S-T-O-M-A-T-A, stomata. So one more also I can draw here. So the little openings, these are the openings inside the leaves, which we cannot see with our naked eyes. One more. Now they make their own food. These leaves, they collect all the three things. What are those three things? What does a plant need to grow? A plant needs to grow water from the soil, carbon dioxide from the air and sunlight to grow. What are those three ingredients they collect? The leaves, water from the soil, carbon dioxide from the air and sunlight. Because chlorophyll, which is present in the leaf, it traps the sunlight energy to make the food. Okay. This whole process is called the photosynthesis. Now, water and minerals from the soil, it is sent up through the stem, it goes to the leaf, and through the main vein and the side vein, it is entered inside the leaf blade, and chlorophyll present in it trapped the sunlight energy and start making the food. And after preparation of the food, it is again through these veins, it is sent up through the main vein, it is sent up to the stem, and from the stem it is sent to all parts of the plant. So this process is called photosynthesis. This photosynthesis, it takes place during the sunlight only. In the presence of sunlight only this will be. So during this process, one gas is given out. What is that gas called? Oxygen. Which gas is given out? Oxygen is given out. So which is needed by all the living things. what we are breathing now is oxygen. That's why we have to plant many plants around our houses to give the fresh air. Carbon dioxide they absorb and they give out oxygen in the daytime only. Night time they will not breathe in carbon dioxide. Okay, they will not breathe in carbon dioxide because sunlight is not present. In the night time they breathe in oxygen and breathe out carbon dioxide. During the daytime they start making the preparation of food. In the next class we will study about how they store their food, in which parts, how do they grow, germination also we will see. And now I will present, I will read out this paragraph. All of you please keep your finger in your textbook. Okay, plants take in carbon dioxide and give out oxygen through these holes. Which holes? What is the name of those holes? Stomata. Leaves are the food factories of a plant. They have a substance called chlorophyll. It helps the leaves absorb energy from sunlight. Then it uses this energy to turn the carbon dioxide and water into sugar. This process is called photosynthesis. Means leaves, they change the carbon dioxide and water into a kind of sugar, which is stored and which is used by the plants to, after preparation of food, the part of the food is used up by the plant and a part of the food is stored in the other parts. What are those parts? We will study in our next class. Thank you.